When life was difficult, especially in India, when people came from really poor homes, very, very difficult life, you know, construction workers or farmers, born into this life with no escape, no way of controlling anything or changing anything or moving out of that zone. Karma was a very easy excuse, very easy explanation to give themselves. Like, I'm born into this life because of something that I did in my past life, and therefore I don't deserve to be a landlord. I deserve to be someone who's working on the land. And that gave them a little bit of solace, saying that I will do everything in this life to make sure my future lives are better. But in today's world, where there's so much access to communication, there's so much access to information, there's so much access to education, thinking that you don't deserve something is really a cop-out. I mean, I don't know if I saw a video, one of these talk video, you know, comedy shows, and he talked about something about people, Indians in America, being very, and this is a word that only South Indians will understand, it's called pavam. Now, pavam also translates to pap, okay? But pavam is someone who's, you know, like, oh, he's just like, doesn't know any better, he's innocent, he's simple, and he's very, you know, whatever comes his way, it's something only a South Indian will understand. And that is something that we are all guilty of being pavam in a situation, not taking advantage, not trying to change anything, but getting into that mental mold of saying, I deserve this. This is all I'm going to get in this life. This is my lot. This is my job. This is my husband. This is my house. This is my life. That pavam mentality of saying, of thinking constantly that, you know, whatever you're getting is okay. There's no need to fight for anything more. There's no need to change anything more. That makes you a victim in your own eyes. So you see yourself as someone who's always going to be oppressed, who's always going to be in this situation where people will take advantage of you. You'll be taken for granted. And you don't do anything because you don't think you deserve anything better than that. Whatever you want in your life, if you don't have a plan that's a little bit bigger than what is, then you can't work towards something. When you have goals, when you have dreams, when you have ideals, when you have these things, it's not to give you a false sense of hope, but it's to give you something to work towards. And that's why I tell you at the beginning of every year, I say, you know, write down what you want to do this year. Write down 6 things that you want for yourself, 6 things that you want to change in your character, 6 things that you want to change in your environment, because as you keep something subliminal, those things change for you. Those things change. And in many ways we are taught, we are kind of forced into this situation. Today we were talking about a relative of my husband who, instead of doing the usual factory job and clerk job, decided to play the bongo, right? And his dad literally threw him out of the house. Literally threw him out. Nobody encouraged him. Nobody thought it was a good idea. Right? Because back in the day, your parents decided what career you were going to take. What you were going to do with your life. Who you were going to marry. What you deserved. in this life? What is your entitlement, right? Your parents decided that for you. So thinking outside the box and thinking, taking another path was not something that you could even consider. If your father was a colonel in the army, that's what you did. If your dad was a surgeon with a practice, that's what you did. So people that are born, mother is a cleaning lady, father is a cleaning, cleans the streets. They don't think they deserve anything bigger than that. Anything better than that. Because they follow in that trend that, you know, this is good enough for me. This is fine. My dad had this, my mom had this, I can do the same thing. So you'll find that up till this current generation, people's, you know, there were generations of people working as servants in India. Their father served the, you know, their father, the grandfather served the grandfather. They just stayed in that job. And if you go to India, you'll see that the person who served you at, say, the chemist store or the, you know, the restaurant at the corner is the same person, the same waiter is doing the same job. I don't know if you all have noticed it when you go back that, for me, the chemist in the corner, chemist, has been the same, the pharmacist, has been the same for the last 20 years in the pharmacy. And sometimes I wonder, you know, don't they wish to change their jobs? Don't they wish to do something different? Don't they feel that they deserve a lot better? You get talking to them and they'll talk about their children. Oh, my daughter is studying here. My daughter is in America. My son, for themselves, they're fine. But they've made these big plans for their children to change everything. And that's what today's technology is. Today's world of information is. It's about widening your horizons. You need to use the technology to think bigger, to think better. I remember somebody telling me that they had a 74-year-old man in Nova studying to be a doctor. I think that's amazing. I think that's amazing to just change and do all the things that you want to do, to understand that if you put in a little bit of effort, if you put a foot in the right direction, you get all the help from the universe. The resistance actually comes here, is all here. It's okay. It's not going to work out for me. You know, I've never worked in an office. I'm not going to find a job. What's the point? That's me talking. To think that, I think at my age that I cannot leave the house and go and do a 9-to-5 job. That I don't deserve that, or that it's not in my plan, or that it's not in my skill set. But if I just went on the online and I searched and I put in an application for a couple of jobs, I can guarantee you that every day 10-15 jobs would be sent to me, and that within a month or within 2 months I might find myself in a brand new career. I have to believe that I deserve that. I deserve that break. That I deserve that stuff. Then I'll go forward doing whatever has to be done. As long as you think you don't deserve it, and this is the victim mentality that we have. This is that power mentality. I'm a poor little housewife. What do I know about this? As long as I think like that, that's all I'm going to get. Because really, you get what you put out. You get what you put out. And we all put in only 50% of the effort we need to. We're scattered. So we're doing a little of this, a little of this, a little of that. You pay attention to what you want and it'll be bigger than you'd ever deserve. You know, I used to find it really amazing that in a classroom, if say the fan was not working, I would never get up and say in the class that, you know, it's really hot in here, can I have the fan on? I just felt that I shouldn't be talking. And I would be amazed at all these people immediately getting up and, you know, expressing their discomfort and, you know, when things were not right, to be so forthright and outgoing and saying what they felt like. And it was something new for me, because I was taught as a child, as an adult, to keep my discomfort to myself, that it's okay to be uncomfortable, that it's okay to give up everything, that it's a value, it's a great asset to sacrifice for everybody else, to sacrifice a lot of yourself for the sake of the family. As a woman, that's what I was taught. And it was quite shocking for me to look at women around. That was, for me, true emancipation, true freedom. When a woman feels the same ability to ask for freedom as a man. And I can tell you that in this country too, in many parts of this country, it's still like that. In a lot of the world, women do not express themselves. When women do not believe that they deserve a better life, they do not believe that they were born with the equal privileges of a man, that all they have to do is to voice their opinion, is to lift themselves out of this mental thinking that you have to sacrifice. You have to sacrifice. You have to give up. You know, a little bit of discomfort. So I gave up my career for my husband. It's okay. Why is it okay? Why is it okay? Because you think you don't deserve to do something different. Something that nobody has done before. To go and be an astronaut and go to the moon. No. And we have been taught this pavam attitude, so that we become like these poor little souls that are, you know, completely with their hands tied up. They can't do anything better than this. And that's not okay. That's like having, you know, voluntarily putting your knee on your neck, not allowing yourself to breathe. You need to be able to be as free as is humanly possible. What is available, you are part of consciousness, universal consciousness. That means every part of it is connected. It isn't that God took a little bit of consciousness and divided it up into a 10 billion parts and put a little bit in everybody and he put a little less in you. That's not how it works. It's all the same. We all have the same opportunities. The only thing that's holding you back is the stuff that's going on in your head. That constant conversation that, you know, I better not say anything. You know, this is what happens, you know, even with women at meetings. I don't know, I better not say anything, because then they might ask me a follow-up question. Then I don't know if I'm going to be able to answer that. Of course you can. Of course you can. And so you train yourself to ask the right questions. To practice what you have to ask and to be able to give the follow-up questions. Don't ever think that you're less than anybody else. Don't ever think that you deserve less of a salary or you deserve less of a position. You deserve it all. And the worst thing for you to do is to feel sorry for yourself. Oh, what am I to do? You know, stuck in this position, stuck at home, locked down, I can't do anything. You know how many people are changing their lives dramatically in this lockdown? Have you just seen the number of different types of masks available? Just look at that and you can see from there. Masks with things hanging, masks with hair ties, masks with, t-shirts matching. People are reinventing themselves. Nothing should hold you back. Nothing should hold you back. If that's what you want to do, go and get it. Go and get it. Stop feeling that you don't deserve better. We're all connected, and it's really a lack of awareness. It's lack of belief in yourself. You know, you've listened to all the stories everyone has said about you, that, you know, you're too timid, or you're too short, or you're too tall, or you've not got the right build, and you won't be good at this. I remember my dad always tell me my wrist was so narrow, you can never play tennis. I would like to show him how much weight I'm lifting these days, right? He'd be really, really shocked at how much I can do. Yeah, we can do a lot more. We are capable of doing everything. We're capable of doing everything. We just feel that this world, we don't deserve to be part of this world. And we hold ourselves back. Open yourself up to possibilities. You are a child, like Joel Osteen always said, you are a child of the Most High God or the Almighty God. That what flows through the entire universe flows through you as well. You are just listening to stories your mind is telling you. You think those stories are true. You believe them wholeheartedly. And now you feel you don't love yourself enough. You don't feel you deserve better. Until you take a little step, somebody will help you along the way. It's not going to, nobody does it alone, you know. You don't have to do anything alone. We are always helped because we're all connected with each other in so many different ways. Someone from somewhere comes up with a plan and a job that's available or some opening that happens, you know, a job opportunity or, you know, an opportunity to start a new career or to learn something different. These opportunities open up for you if you take the first step. You've got to be courageous enough to step out of that comfort zone. And when once you do that, you get the help from the universe. You have it in you. You deserve a better life. You deserve all the money that you're getting. You deserve the house that you have. You deserve whatever is coming your way. What you don't deserve is the misery, the suffering, the self-deprecation, the feeling that you're the victim, the sadness, the self-pity, that you don't deserve. Nobody deserves it. Everyone deserves to be happy. Everyone deserves to walk freely without the burden of life on their shoulders. You know, to just be free and to be happy and to laugh and to smile all the time. And to do all that they have to do effortlessly. Effortlessly, just being there and not thinking, oh, I'm doing this, but I could be doing that, but I'm doing this, but I should have done that. It is your mind pulling you in different directions, telling you, oh, you could be exercising, you could be walking instead, you're working. And then when you're exercising and walking, you'll feel the guilt, oh my God, I'm exercising, I should be working. It's never really good enough for your ego. It's never good enough. Stay present. Stay focused. It's only the awareness of meditation that gives you an idea about how your mind is working. Nothing else will tell you. Nobody knows. Doesn't matter what face you present here. Nobody knows what is going on inside. Only you know. That constant conversation that you're having with yourself, only you know. And you don't even realize it until, you know, like the 5th, 10th, 20th talk. You don't realize what's happening.